In this video, we are going to solve a system of linear equation using Gauss elimination. Basically, we will take some examples and see how we can use row operations to solve the system of linear equations. So, let us consider this system of linear equation first. So, which is given as minus x1 plus x2 minus x3 equal to 0. Let us consider the second equation to be 2x1 plus 2x2 minus 2x3 equal to 2, and the third equation to be x2 plus x3 equal to minus 1. So these three equations make this system of linear equation. So we can write the corresponding matrix of this system of equation as minus 1 1 minus 1 2, 2, minus 2, 0, 1, 1. So, if you see the first equation, the coefficient of x1 is minus 1, which I write in this first place. Coefficient of x2 is plus 1. Coefficient of x3 is minus 1. Similarly, coefficient of x1 in the second equation is 2. In coefficient of x2 is also 2. And coefficient of x3 is minus 2. There is no x1 in the third equation, so the coefficient is 0. The coefficient of x2 is 1, and coefficient of x3 is also 1. So this is basically the coefficient matrix. We generally denote it by A. The variable we can write in this matrix, x, such that this is a column matrix, x1, x2, and x3. So, if you multiply A with x, you will get a, so A is a 3 cross 3 matrix, and this is a 3 cross 1 matrix. So, Ax will be a 3 cross 1 matrix. And that is basically this terms, constant term, this 3 cross 1 matrix. We generally denote it by B. So, B is 0 to minus 1. So this gives us this form Ax equal to B, where A is our coefficient matrix and B is basically the right hand side of the equations. So if we take A and there is a line in between and then we write B, this is known as the augmented matrix. So, using this augmented matrix, we can solve this system of linear equation. So, let us see how we can do it. So, let us write the augmented matrix first for this system of equation. So, augmented matrix will be minus 1, 1, minus 1, 2, 2, minus 2, 0, 1, 1, and then B is our 0, 2, minus 1, and we put a line in between them to separate these two. So, this is our augmented matrix in this system of linear equation. So, let us start with this augmented matrix. So, our first element, first non-zero element in first row is minus 1. We have to make it 1. So, basically we will try to make it in reduced row echelon form. So, at first we have to make the first pivot element to be 1. It is minus 1. So, basically we will do minus of R1, which will gives us 1, minus 1, 1, 0, and the remaining rows will be same. Now, we have to make this element to be 0. Basically, we have to make all the elements in the first column except the first pivot element to be 0. The third element, third row, the element in the third row is already 0. So, we have to make only the element in the second row to be 0. So, what we have to do, we have to multiply 2 with the first row and subtract it from the second. So, R2 minus 2R1. So, let us see what it will give us. The first row will remain unchanged. The second row will be 0. Then 2 minus of minus 2, that is 4. And here it will be minus 4. Here it will be 2, and the third row will remain as it is. Now, the first non-zero element in the second row is 4. So, this is our pivot element. We have to make it 1. So, what we will do? We will take 1 by 4 of R2. So, it will give us 1, minus 1, 1, 0. First row will remain unchanged. So, this will give us 1, minus 1 and here it will be half. And the third row will remain unchanged. Now, we have to make the element below this pivot element to be 0. So we have to make this one to be 0. So, basically, we have to just subtract R2 from R3. So, we will get the first row will be same because we are not doing any operation of that. The second is also same. And the third one will be 0 and this will be 1 of minus 1, that is 2, and minus half minus 1, that will be minus 3 by 2. Now, the first non-zero element in the third row is 2. So, we have to make it 1. So, we will do half of R3. It will give us 1 minus 1, 1, 0. 0, 1, minus 1, half, 0, 0, 1 and minus 3 by 4. So, this is already, now this is in row echelon form. So, using this row echelon form itself, we can solve this equation or else we can go to the reduced row echelon form to solve this equation. For that, we have to make all these elements to be 0. But before going that, from here, let us try to solve this equation. So, what is this? Here, this first portion, this first 3 by 3 portion is basically our new coefficient matrix after row echelon form, after this set of row operations. So, this is our new matrix R, x equal to b, where R dash is 1, minus 1, 1, 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 1. This is my R dash. Our x will remain same and our new b prime, so this will be b prime, will be this. So, the new equations are x1 minus x2 plus x3 is 0, x2 minus x3 is half and x3 is minus 3 by 4. So, from the last one, what we are getting, x3 is equal to minus 3 by 4. So, we are basically solve the value for x3. Now, if we put x3 in the second equation, we will get x2 minus x3, which is minus 3 by 4. So, it will be plus 3 by 4 equal to half, which gives us x2 equal to half minus 3 by 4, which is minus 1 by 4. And now, we have got x2 and x3, and if we put this in the first equation, which is x1 minus x2 means 1 by 4 plus x3 means minus 3 by 4, that is 0. So, x1 will be so we get x1 is half. So, we have solved the equation and we get x1 to be half, x2 to be minus 1 by 4 and x3 to be minus 3 by 4. So, this is the solution and you can see that this is a unique solution. So, this system of linear equation has unique solution and the solution is given by this. Now, in this example, we have already seen that this is in row echelon form. So, let us try to reduce this further to reduce row echelon form. So, basically, we have to make these three element 0. So, for making the element in the first row in second column to be 0, we have to basically add the second row to the first one. So, R2, R1 plus R2, this will give us 1 0 0 0 1 minus 1, here it will be half because we are adding the second row, so this will be unchanged. The second row will remain unchanged and the third row will also remain unchanged. So we have already made this first row in 1 0 0. So only one element is remaining now, this minus 1. So what we have to do, we have to add the third row to the second one. So R2 plus R3. So it will give us 1 0 0 half. So first row will remain unchanged. 0 1 0 and half minus 3 by 4. And 0 0 1 minus 3 by 4. The third row will remain unchanged. So which is nothing but this matrix. Half 0 1 0. Half minus 3 by 4 is minus 1 by 4. 0 0 1. Minus 3 by 4. So you can see that this is in row reduced echelon form or reduced row echelon form. So our new matrix R double prime X is B, where R double prime is the identity matrix. X is same. Our variables and B is half minus 1 by 4 and minus 3 by 4. So you can see that x1 is half, x2 is minus 1 by 4 and x3 is minus 3 by 4. So from reduced echelon form we can directly solve this equation, or else what we have done in the previous page, we from the row echelon form we solve the equation by putting the values from the last variable x3. So here these operations are doing the same thing in matrix form rather than putting the values of the variable from the last. So this is the solution of the system of equation we have taken, and this is the unique solution for this system. Now let us see the geometric representation as we have seen in the earlier week. So the first equation here was minus x1 plus x2 minus x3 equal to 0. So in xyz plane, so suppose our x1 is basically the variable x, the x2 is variable y and the x3 is variable z. So we can represent this as a plane in this xyz coordinate system. So the first equation will denote this plane. It will pass through origin, as you can see, and this is the plane minus x1 plus x2 minus x3 equal to 0, rather minus x plus y minus z equal to 0. So the second plane will look like this. Second plane was 2x1 plus 2x2 minus 2x3 equal to 2. Or in this coordinate system, it is 2x plus 2y minus 2z equal to 2. Basically, we are changing the variable x1, x2, x3 to xyz to identify this in this coordinate system, because in general in coordinate system we take the variable to be x, y and z. So this is the second plane, and the third plane will look like this. That was y plus z equal to minus 1. So in the equation it was x2 plus x3 equal to minus 1. So this is the third plane. Now let us see the first and the second equation where they intersect with each other. So this is the first plane and this is the second plane. So in this straight line they will intersect with each other. So this is the solution of the first two equations. Now if we see the second and third equation, we will see, so this is the third equation. So this is the solution of second and third equation, which is given by this straight line. So in this straight line, these two planes intersect with each other. So let us consider the three equations at a time and see where they are intersecting. So there are two lines, where one line denotes the solution of first two equation and the second line denotes the solution of second and third equation. And you can see that one point these two lines are intersecting, and that is basically the solution of these three equation, where these three plane are intersecting with each other. So this point is basically the solution of these three plane, the intersection of these three plane rather, and the solution of the three equation we have considered. So as these three plane are intersecting at a single point, the solution is unique. Thank you.